Oh, out of slavery to freedom in Christ. And in this we rejoice and have peace, which the world cannot give or understand. And so during this difficult time, we ask that you would sustain us and help us to remain firm and confident in our faith in you. Father, as the number of COVID cases increases in our nation, we ask for your protection and provisions for those on the front lines, those essential workers, and especially we pray for those who are caring for and treating these patients. We ask, Lord God, for the vaccines to be quickly and safely brought to market so that it would be available to all. And we pray for the healing and comfort for those who are sick. Lord, we ask for wisdom for our leaders as they continue to lead in these unprecedented times. We pray, Lord God, for unity for our nation. And we pray, Lord God, that we would show love and compassion for one another. And we pray for the missionaries around the world as they continue to serve you in the midst of tremendous need. We ask for your encouragement and strength for them. And we also pray for our church family, that you will continue to protect and provide as you have all these months. And we are so grateful. We are grateful also for the ways that you've led and provided for our church move. And we ask that you would continue to be with our task team to finalize the church move. And we also pray for the children's pastor, that you will bring the right person to our church to be the spiritual shepherd to our children. And Lord, we also continue to pray for our pastoral staff as they serve you faithfully during these difficult times, that you would encourage them, strengthen them, and bless them, and provide for them. And Lord, we pray, Lord God, for our church to continue to grow in you, that we would continue, Father, to fulfill. this morning, and that the Spirit of God would be in our midst to make our hearts one in Christ. Thank you, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
We know God will provide the right person and
God works through your prayers. So you have a part to play in this important part. Let's go to the Word of God this morning. Before we do that, I want to direct your attention one more, two more things actually. Sorry, kind of slipped in mind. Want to let you know that the beautiful flowers have been arranged by Sister Susan Park. She came by yesterday and dedicated the flowers to the Lord. And another announcement is Mr. Beckon O. Begin, Sungus Hanim and his wife Sabana Omani, we call them Omani and Abonim, as a title of endearment. They are moving away to LA this coming Tuesday. They've been with us forever. They've been the long-time disciples of Christ here at Cornerstone Church ever since, Redwood City. It's kind of sad in my heart, but he's always been a prayer warrior for us, and he's been on missions before, 2-3 years to China. Now he's back retired, and now circumstances has that he has to move down to LA. So if you know him personally, please give him a call and pray for him and bless them and appreciate them for what they've done for Cornerstone Church. Let's get to the Word of God this morning, and we will be reading from the last chapter, last paragraph of the book of Acts. The very last part of the book of Acts. And I'll be reading from Acts chapter 28, verses 23 to 31. And I'll read 23 and on, and you can follow with your ears and with your eyes. But I want to ask that we all read verse 31 together. This is the very last verse of the book of Acts. I think it'll be meaningful as we finish it. Read it together. Chapter 28, verse 23. When they had appointed a day for him, they came to him at his lodging in a great number. From morning till evening, he expounded to them, testifying to the kingdom of God and trying to convince them about Jesus, both for the law of Moses and from the prophets. And some were convinced by what he said, but others disbelieved, and disagreeing among themselves, they departed after Paul had made one statement. The Holy Spirit was right in saying to your fathers through Isaiah the prophet, go to this people and say, you will indeed hear but never understand. You will indeed see but never perceive. For this people's heart has grown dull, and with their ears they can barely hear, and their eyes they have closed, lest they should see with their eyes and hear with their ears, and understand with their heart, and turn, and I would heal them. Therefore, let it be known to you that this salvation of God has been sent to the Gentiles. They will listen. He lived there 2 whole years at his own expense, welcomed all who came to him. And let's read together if you can, proclaiming the kingdom of God and preaching about the Lord Jesus Christ with all boldness and without hindrance. Amen and amen. For this season of fall, it doesn't feel like fall anymore, it's kind of cold right here. Throughout this season, we've been reading the book of Acts together with a broad brushstroke. Right? We haven't seen the detailed every story, every episode in the book of Acts. And indeed it has many, many stories, wonderful, beautiful stories, true stories of the Acts of the Holy Spirit. Remember from chapter 1, and we're at chapter 28 right now. Chapter 1, how Jesus commissioned the disciples and commissioned us to be his witnesses to the end of the world. And so we called our series, as Jesus commanded us to do, we called our series Martus, Witness in Greek. And we've started from the first sermon of Peter on that day of Pentecost when the Holy Spirit came down and filled everybody's hearts. And he preached this powerful message, which was the start of the Acts of the Holy Spirit. We also found Stephen, who emanated a beautiful fragrance aroma to the Lord as the first martyr witness. And after that, we saw a team of witnesses converting this young man called Saul. And the teamwork and the Holy Spirit was so great and so powerful that this soul, who was a persecutor of church, became Paul, the apostle, and the apostle to the Gentiles. In fact, the Gentile ministry grew, and we saw how the first Gentile church of Antioch became the mission center of the world, and they sent missionaries out to Asia and also to Europe. And we saw many converts coming to Christ, not only from the Jews, but also from the Gentiles. We also saw, because of now Gentiles being incorporated into the Jewish church, and the Gentiles church, it's just one church, Jesus Christ. There was conflict between the gospel and the law, right? And so the church beautifully came together, the Jerusalem church, and a council came together and resolved that issue once and for all. The amazing thing about the book of Acts this semester for Cornerstone is that as we followed every book, every chapter of this book, Holy Spirit was speaking to us, you and I, personally, and he has some amazing things this year. As the Holy Spirit challenged us, we resolved to be the witnesses of Jesus Christ. I know many people have dedicated, committed their lives to sharing the gospel wherever they can, wherever they are. I also remember people who have five people they're praying for to be led by the Holy Spirit. See the open doors, opportunities for them to share Jesus Christ too. I know many of you have been praying for that. Also, we heard from Pastor Aaron Son. He's sharing his experience of the Troas moment, how God opened Europe for Paul, and how God opened new opportunities for Pastor Aaron, and how God has opened a new worship place for us. And we came to a decision last Sunday at our members meeting. Just like the Jerusalem church, we prayerfully sought God's direction, and in faith, you and I, all of us, have made a decision, commitment to follow Jesus Christ wherever he leads. And beautifully, the church has decided unanimously together for the next step. Today's story is about the last part of Paul's journey, the very end. Of course, this is not the end of his life, right? But this is the last part of Paul's journey that's recorded in the book of Acts. That's why it's the last part, right? We have a question though. Where do we go from here? As Jesus commissioned us to live this disciple life, this Jesus witness life, how can we continue this life of the witness? Because the fact of the matter is, it's not easy. It's easy, relatively speaking, to go on a mission trip. It's easy to invite somebody to church once in a while, maybe for as a program during the fall. Maybe it's just easy to think about these issues, resolve to be a witness, but how could we do this for the rest of our lives? That's another issue, right? If you're going on a day trip, or if you're going on a week trip, or a month-long trip, your attitude in preparation for the trip is very different, right? All these, as the longevity of the trip, your preparation should be different. Likewise, as we prepare for a lifetime of witness of Jesus Christ, we need to be prepared. We need to understand what is entailed in the life of a continual witness of Jesus Christ. This morning, you and I want to look at how to be a continual witness for Jesus. How can we continue the path that Jesus has commissioned us on? How to continue to be a witness is the question I want to raise this morning. From the book of Acts, the last chapter of Acts. The first answer is this. You and I have to remember. You and I have to know something. And the knowledge is this, that there are other witnesses of the gospel. Can we say it together, wherever you are? Know that there are other witnesses of the gospel. Know that there are other witnesses of the gospel. And indeed, that was the secret of Paul's longevity in his witness ministry. We find Paul having traveled from Jerusalem. Remember last 2 weeks ago, not last Sunday, last Sunday was Thanksgiving, but two Sundays ago, we saw Paul in the court, in the hearing, the justice system in Caesarea Philippi, the Caesarea Maritime around Mediterranean Sea, and he was tried before Festus, and King Agrippa, right? He was in chains. Said, I want everybody to become like me, Christian, except for these chains. He was being a little bit funny. Nobody was laughing. Anyway, so he made the trip to Caesar. He wanted to see Caesar and appeal to Caesar because God had told him that you must stand before Caesar in trial, and you shall be my witness before him. So Paul, with one focus, he complied, he was arrested, and he was transported. He was in the process of being transported to the great city of Rome. But there was a problem. The season of the year was in the winter time. And in the winter time, Mediterranean Sea did not behave. There were storms and winds and violent weather in these seas. Show us the map, Pastor. So they started from Jerusalem. You can see he traveled to Cyrene, the big island in the Mediterranean Sea. And he made it all the way across. But then there was this big storm. The Bible even names the storm in chapter 27. This was a famous storm, and 20 something of them got shipwrecked, right? And only by the grace of God they were able to sustain their life. They were shipwrecked onto this island called Malta, right underneath, south of the Italian peninsula. And they stayed there for 3 months. Paul and the company stayed there for 3 months until another ship came by to take them to land. And Paul was able to continue his journey onto the peninsula and into Rome.